All right, so welcome everyone to today's financial wellness webinar for state employees and state retirees. This is our first time that we will be offering this series, so I'm super excited to be with you all today. My name is Christine Callahan, and I work in the State Treasurer's Office of Economic Empowerment. Before we get into today's program, I'm just going to go over a few quick housekeeping items. So just a little bit about the Office of Economic Empowerment. The Office of Economic Empowerment is a department within the Office of the Treasurer and Receiver General of Massachusetts, tasked with supporting, advocating, and facilitating policies that empower all Massachusetts residents. So what does our office do? Our programs serve women, families, high school students, veterans, and seniors, and our priorities include financial education, closing the race and gender wage gap, racial equity, college affordability, and promoting STEM education. So just a few disclosures. This is a Zoom webinar and we are recording. This webinar may be for future use uploaded onto a public website. And please note any information shared through the questions functions will be anonymous. However, the chat record is subject to public record laws and as such is not anonymous. So just a few housekeeping items. Like I said, it is a webinar, so you're only gonna be able to see our panelists and not the other participants. You can use the chat feature throughout the entire webinar to communicate with the panelists. I encourage you all to ask questions throughout the webinar. And please complete our post survey so that we can continue to improve this program. So just a little bit about the financial wellness program for state employees and retirees. This is the first program of its kind to provide state employees and retirees resources to make informed financial decisions throughout one's lifetime. I'm super excited today to talk a bit more about one of the programs that we're able to offer through the financial wellness program. So what we're here to talk to you all today about is the Enrich Portal. The Enrich Portal provides state employees and retirees an online portal to create custom financial education content specific to your life stage. And then there's also a few other initiatives that our office has that you're eligible to use that will be dropped in the chat, but we're here to focus on the Enrich Portal. So before we get started, I am just going to launch two poll questions just to kind of get a sense of who is in the audience. So I'm going to launch the poll and give you all a few seconds to complete them. The first question is, which of the following categories applies to you? Are you currently employed by the state of Massachusetts, currently retired from the state, prefer not to say? And then the second question is, have you created a personal account on Enrich? Yes, no, or prefer not to stay? I'll just give it a few more seconds. All right, well, thank you all for participating in the poll. I am now going to be able to share the results. So everyone joining us today is a state employee, which is great. Welcome, fellow state employees. And then have you created a personal account on the Enrich Portal? So 67% of respondents have and 33% have not. Those of you who have not created a portal, well, today is a great day because we're going to walk you through all of the steps to create a portal. So before I introduce our fabulous co-host, I'm just going to talk a little bit more about Enrich. So what I really like about Enrich is that we're all able to get custom financial education that's specific to our life and our financial needs. So now, without further ado, I'm going to pass it over to Sam Evans, who is the VP of Business Development at Enrich, and Sam is going to walk us all through on how to create an Enrich portal and why the Enrich portal is so important. So Sam, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks, Christine. Appreciate it. Thanks for the introduction. So I'm excited to share this with everyone here. So both the, you know, those of you watching the recording and those of you that are here live today. So I appreciate you making time. And what I'm going to do today is just really give you an overview of the portal, how it works, how it can benefit you, how you can use it as a resource. And just if you haven't used it yet, this will give you an overview of kind of how to get started. And you know, explain why it makes sense to create a profile and so on. So let me share my screen here and make sure everyone can see that. Did that flip over okay, Christine?
Yes, I can see it, thank you.
Okay, excellent. So here we are at the actual site, and I think we have, you can see the link on my screen here, or we have it in the chat. And if you're joining with us or watching this recording, take a second and open up a browser, and you're going to want to visit the portal because we're going to do we're going to walk through an exercise together and make this a little bit more interactive. So the address is massfinwell.enrich.org. And once you go there, you're going to essentially see what you can see on my screen here. And it's important to point out for those of you that may have already been here before, you'll kind of realize that you can browse the portal without creating a profile. So you're not going to be able to see everything, but it's going to allow you to kind of explore it a little bit. You can look at some of the topics, you can use the search functionality, you can discover what courses and tools are available. So you may be wondering, well, if that's the case, then why should I, you know, why do I need to create a profile? Well, the benefit of doing this is if you explore the portal, you'll see that we have literally thousands of pieces of content within the Enrich portal. Too much. To just try and explore in a day or a week or even a month. So the benefit of creating a profile is that we're going to use machine learning and algorithms and intelligence to start to learn about who you are as an individual. And then we're going to personalize the experience for you so that we will essentially filter out the content that doesn't really apply to your situation. So for example, if you don't have children and you're not considering you know, how you need to save for college education, well, you know, we'll discover that, and then we'll filter that extra content out. And we'll also learn about your personal situation enough to be able to kind of meet you where you are in your own financial journey and help you get started and focused on the content that's really going to be most relevant to you. So the way this works, you know, we're going to prompt you to create a profile. So if you're just coming here and you haven't already created a profile, you'll be prompted to sign up. So very basic, first name, last name, your email. Can be whatever email you prefer, and then a password, and then you can sign up. And then your browser will typically remember your credentials anyway. So I created a profile for myself this morning. And what now appears that was not there before is when I log in, I now see a dashboard that's personalized to me. So one of the things I did was, you know, you can click on this icon here. These are my daughters, and you can save your own photo to kind of personalize this a little bit. You can see here, we can choose a background photo to kind of align with your top financial goal. So if my top goal would be, you know, right now is to invest, for example, I can click on that and I have kind of a nice background that associates with what I'm trying to do. What'll happen is if you're creating a profile right now, you will see, you'll be challenged to take a financial checkup. And this is really where a lot of the magic in the portal starts to happen. And what we're doing here is we're covering, we're asking you some questions to see again, you know, who is this individual on the other side of the screen? How can we help them? How can we give them guidance and get them on their financial journey? So this is a questionnaire. It's dynamic. So depending on your answers, we'll add or remove questions. But we're asking things like money basics, asking about credit, debt, future goals, are you financially protected, and so on. You can see here, it just takes about 4.5 minutes. We are going to go through this together because it's a great way to get initial engagement with the portal. So I'll kind of give you an overview, but feel free to click through this yourself to take the questions. And the way this also works is that we will repeat some of these questions every 120 days or so to get an update on how you're making progress in achieving your milestones. So first of all, it's gonna ask date of birth here. So I'm just gonna put in some values. And then click next, asking me if I'm currently employed. So yes, I am. Not sure about needing an additional job in the future. And then it's asking me about financial stress. So you really want to answer this as accurately as you can, because for example, if I indicate I have no financial stress, we're not going to serve any content around how to manage that or understand how we can be of assistance. So I'll put here, you know, the typical response on the portal is around about a 3.75 on average for the first visit. But the good news is we consistently see financial stress levels decline as time goes by and you continue to use the portal. So things that may concern me about my finances, you know, retiring, mortgage, for example, I have a couple of kids. So, thinking about student loans, saving for college, supporting family. And you can see as I go through here, we're kind of letting you know from an interest standpoint how you compare to other users of the platform. So you can see here it says 20% of users answer they feel a 4 out of 5 stress level. But don't worry, we can help you take control of your finances. And by taking this checkup, you're already on your way. Then it's asking me which bank accounts I have. So I can indicate that. Do I have 3 to 6 times your monthly expenses saved in an emergency fund? In this case, I'm gonna say, no, I do not. How often am I budgeting today? You know, is it maybe once a year? Is it never? You can see I'm continuing to get updates here as well. Do any parents, children, or family members rely on you for financial support? Yes, they do. Are you a parent who's supporting a college student? I am not. And then what types of debt do I have? So I have mortgage, my wife has student loan debt. And I have car payments as well. Now you can see we're moving on to credit and debt here. So you're usually able to pay your monthly bills without going into debt. I'm gonna say yes here. Do you know what your credit score is? I'll say fair. And then what goals are you saving for? So this is important. Something to realize is that this enriched portal is not just for helping people that may be under financial duress or need to rebuild their credit or unable, you know, don't have their emergency savings. This goal is really for every, this portal really is for everyone. And it's designed to help you reach future goals as well. You know, whether it's saving to go on vacation, college funds, whatever it might be, you know, parenthood, we have an aspirational element to the portal. So we want to make sure that we're helping you achieve goals as well as improving your overall financial situation as well. So I'll indicate a couple here. And what this is doing is, as I'm making my choices, again, this is helping to align the experience that I'm going to have, and it's going to find the best content for me. So moving across from future goals, We're then going to move into other questions around financial protection. So I'm answering a few additional questions here about retirement. Do I have an employer retirement plan? Am I getting a contribution? Am I getting the maximum match that I possibly can? And then questions around education. Do I think I'll be going back to school? I'm going to say no here. And then we've moved on to financial protection. So what kinds of insurance do I have? Maybe I don't have life, for example, have health coverage, but this will help, again, determine the type of content that I'll see. So a couple more questions about protection to make sure that we're covering all aspects. Do I have a will or a trust? If I indicate no, obviously I'll be recommended guidance around moving towards that. There's an option here to type in questions, responses in terms of what do you think you need the most help with? This is something that we look at on the Enrich side, and we use it to determine are we meeting the content goals of our users. So it's great if you can provide feedback. If you look through the portal, or if there's something very specific that's not there, you know, let us know and we can take the feedback and make sure that we have that information. This information is just to help Commonwealth understand who's engaging with the portal. So that's useful information. Asking if I have a smart plan. Am I contributing the minimum allowed, more than the minimum to that plan? Asking questions about saving for children's education. And then once I'm through that, it's going to take me back to my dashboard. And the difference that we're going to see here now is because I've gone through that quick exercise, and it'll be faster as you do it, if you do it solo, is that now I'm starting to see recommendations, okay? So you can see here, there's something around insurance, life and disability, because I indicated that I did not have that type of coverage. Questions around budget, articles around budgeting, retirement, and so on. So at this point, I can start interacting with the recommendations that the portal has. You can see here, there are also recommendations for courses that are going to make sense for me as well. So I can work with those. Alternatively, you may come here because you have a specific financial question or goal that you need to have answered. So you're free to navigate the portal and search for content on that particular topic. So let me take you quickly through the remainder of the main areas within the portal. So we have our topics hub here. And you can see here we have some content that's listed here that might maybe kind of more newsworthy. What's happening with taxes, because we're in tax season right now, what's happening with taxes and COVID and so on. I can look for a particular topic of interest for me and click on this. These are hub buttons. And then I have recommendations as well. So here's the latest content that we've published. The great thing with Enrich is you can come back almost on a daily basis and you will find that we have new content that's being published. Again, we try and make it timely, relevant to what's going on. You can see there's an article here on the latest legislation and what that's going to mean for you. We had a recent article on the whole GameStop situation and what was happening there. Trending content is looking to see what others are looking at in the portal, what's of most interest. And so you can look at that as well. News information. And then it's giving me recommendations kind of based on what the portal knows about me so far. So the more you engage with Enrich, the more it learns about you and the more it can narrow content for you that it thinks that you're going to be highly likely to be interested in. Another great thing about Enrich is it learns how you like to learn. So what that means is you start navigating the portal. If it notices that you are really looking at a lot of infographics, for example, or it notices that you tend to prefer to learn by watching videos, it's going to give you these recommendations more likely in video format. So we really like the fact that, you know, different folks like to learn different ways. I personally like to read articles at my own speed, as well as looking at, I do like videos as well. So it's going to allow you to learn using the kind of preferred medium of your choice. Additional recommendations here. If you remember, I indicated I hadn't saved fully for the 3 to 6 month emergency fund. I have some choices here around looking at articles. And if I click see more, it's going to give me that additional, those additional recommendations. So that's the topics hub. If you're not, if you're browsing and you're not finding what you want, you can simply come and use the search functionality. And then in doing that, you can search for a particular topic. Let's say if you're interested in a 529 plan and you just want to find everything about that, you can see we have 33 results for that. And you can kind of pick and choose how you'd like to learn about that topic. So would you like to watch a video, look at an infographic, or read an article? The goal with the Enrich portal is for employees and for retirees. We want you to feel like this is a one-stop shop for really almost any financially related question. There's nothing worse than trying to go online. You know, if you go online and Google 529 plans, it's just completely overwhelming. It's difficult to know where to begin. You don't know if you're clicking on a site that's trying to sell you something and maybe giving biased advice. Great thing about Enrich is we don't sell any products or services. We're completely impartial. Our goal here is just to provide education. And then once you're educated, you can then go out and activate that knowledge and then move forward and achieve that milestone. So here again in the 529 search results, this is something you can browse through. You can look at something that seems to make sense. And then read a few, you know, read two or three articles, perhaps watch a video, and all of this should be a great resource. So I know that this is one of the goals of the Office of Economic Empowerment is further education and so on. So this we have excellent resources around adult education and certainly something that's worth searching. So almost 300 results around student life, private loans, understanding repayments and so on. So that's the topics hub. That's the library that again, we try to personalize for you. The next major area that I'd like to share is the financial wellness courses. As you can see here, I have some recommendations. You know, foundational course like budgeting, creating a financial plan for your priorities and goals is a great course to start off with as well, because it's kind of going to give you that roadmap of here's the sequence that you're likely going to want to follow as you move down that particular path. We have over 20 courses within the course hub. Definitely recommend taking a detailed look through there. And if I click on one of these, so for example, let's take a look here, creating that financial plan. If you click on a course, it's going to tell you this is what it's about. Here's what you're going to learn. So you can make sure that this is, you know, these are the topics that you're interested in learning about. And then there's an overview here. So this one says it's up to 20 minutes long. Difficulty level is low. And the great thing about our courses is that it's not a one size fits all. What we do that's unique here is we're going to ask you a few questions before you take the course, see where you are in terms of creating a financial plan. And then we're going to test your knowledge as well to see how familiar you are. Now, based on what we learn about you during the setup, we're going to actually potentially remove the more basic modules from this course that would not really be needed by you. You may feel that they're too basic, that you weren't really getting value out of those preliminary modules. So we can shorten this up and make sure that you're staying engaged, because we really want you to complete the course. And the reason for that is at the end of every course, you'll get a personalized action plan that's going to give you some next steps based on what we learned from you. And you'll be able to access that action plan at any time as well. This particular course has up to 8 minutes of on-demand video. We have interactive exercises. There are quizzes that we give you feedback. And then, of course, the action plan with a certificate of completion. So that is the course hub. Last couple of things I'll show you are the tools area. Now, the thing with the tools is many of these are featured within the courses. So if you take a course on home buying or on retirement or on budgeting, you'll actually encounter these tools as part of that course. The great thing about the courses is you'll start to apply your own situation using the tools. The system will remember what you put in. And then while you're taking the course, you'll be given those new recommendations, new behaviors you can adopt to further improve your financial situation. So tools that you would expect to find are going to be here. Of course, we have an excellent budgeting tool. All of these tools, the entire portal can be accessed on a smartphone or a tablet, works just as well. It's all mobile optimized. Retirement analyzer tools, that'll show you if you're on track for retirement or what you would need to do to get on track. If you have or someone in your family has student loans, we have a student loan snapshot tool. So with that, we can import the federal student loans into the system, and then it'll show you to the dollar what your different repayment options are. So it could be you may want to go with an extended graduated payment, which will be very low, but will have a lot of interest to pay over time. You'll be able to see all of those numbers to the dollar. You may go for a more straightforward repayment option, higher payments, but much shorter time to pay off. And much less interest is paid as well. So another great tool to experiment with. In addition to all of these custom tools by Enrich, you'll also have access to calculators. These are great, you know, in terms of making educated decisions, doing the math and seeing, you know, what's going to make sense for you. Is that car that I'm looking for going to be affordable? Do I need to look at something different? And so on. And then one of the tools that I personally really like to highlight is we have a Your Money Personality Assessment. So for you, those of you, again, watching live or watching the recording, I'll try and wrap up ahead of the hour slot we have here. And this is something I definitely recommend you take a look at. It's a fun activity. What we're doing is we're trying to help you understand the why behind the money decisions that you make. What, you know, why am I in the financial situation that I'm in today, whether it's good or bad or could be better? This will help you to understand that. So it's very much like a Myers-Briggs personality assessment, but we're looking at your money personality type in these different categories. And again, this is under tools. So I can show you, I took this very, very quickly earlier today. And you can see this is a booklet that I received. This explains why we're doing this, the science behind it, how we're doing it. And then I can see, you know, the first category, my emotional relationship is I'm cautious. And this is what it means. This is how I compare to others. And here are some strengths and some challenges of having a cautious approach. So, you know, strengths are that, you know, obviously I'm careful, I'm trying to be responsible. I'm prepared for things like emergencies, but then there are challenges with every personality type. You know, maybe I'm not looking at things like retirement, and I'm too conservative with my funds, and I'm not seeing the growth that maybe some of my peers are seeing because I'm in a very conservative, cautious kind of mutual fund situation. So then this will also show you, you know, some action items for that personality type. And again, there are quite a few different categories that we look at here. This is personal finance after all. You really want to understand your personal relationship with finances. That can be a big missing piece in having success. Most folks understand concepts like don't excessively use credit cards, but if we know the right thing to do, but we're consistently not following the best path, that's often attributable to our personality type. And if we can understand that, we can get closer to having financial success. The final area I was going to show you today is we have a COVID-19 hub. We update this at least once a week. I think this was just updated on Monday. And what we're doing here is we are providing, you know, all of the resources within the portal, but also resources external to the portal as well, around things like getting mortgage relief, for example, understanding legislation and how that's impacting your personal finances, and just general advice and minimizing stress during the pandemic, things you can do with your stimulus check. That was a very popular one, I seem to recall, and so on. So again, our goal here is to try and make this for the you retirees and employees to really be a one-stop shop, but really your first stop in trying to find answers to your financial questions. So Christine, I think I feel like I've covered just about everything that we have within the portal in terms of a very high level first look. There's a lot here to explore. You'll see here that there is also a chat functionality. So if you have a question and you want to talk to someone real time, get some guidance on, you know, where resources are within the portal, you can do that. But the search functionality will you know, should help with most of your questions. But that's really what we wanted to share with you with this initial overview today, just to get you started. And you know, we're working continually with Christine to take feedback on the portal, how we can improve it, content that we can add and promote and so on. So we'd love your feedback, and we want this to be a big success and get lots of engagement.
Awesome, Sam. Thank you so much for going over the Enrich portal. It definitely is a one-stop shop for financial wellness needs, no matter where you are in your journey, which is great. And I've taken my money personality quiz, and it definitely, as I read through, I can definitely see the way I spend my money, and it makes sense to me. So I encourage you all to do that. With that, I'm going to go ahead and open it up for questions. Does anyone in the audience have any questions for Sam or myself? And we just dropped in the chat our mass.gov FinWell website, where you can access the Enrich portal and a few other financial wellness initiatives that our office has. I don't see any questions from the audience. Well, if anyone is still thinking, I guess, Sam, I have a question for you. If someone maybe was a little hesitant to open up and start an Enrich account, what advice would you give to them?
Yeah, great question. So I would say that, you know, if I log out here, you can browse the portal anonymously. Okay, so you can come in, and this is for this very reason, that when you come to the portal, it's prompting you to create an account. We want you to do it, but we're not making it the first step. We're not making it mandatory. So what I would recommend is Use it and explore it and see if you can find value in the tool, and then make a decision. You know, if you think that taking a course for you or a family member would make sense. And again, this can be shared. So we want the whole household to be financially well. So, you know, individuals can create accounts and get their own personalized recommendations. But just you can explore a lot of the portal and look at the content, see if you're finding value. And if you'd like that guidance and the personalization, that's why we'd recommend that you create a profile. And that, you know, this is, you know, we're fully data compliant. We're not selling any information. If that's a concern some folks may have that, oh, you know, if I create a profile, then, you know, my information's gonna, you know, I'm gonna start receiving mortgage offers or things along those lines. None of that's going to happen. That's a decision that we've had since day one of our organization, is to be truly independent so that we're not having any bias in the recommendations that we're giving or the educational information that we're providing. So yeah, just experiment, play around with it, search a topic or a goal that you have. And if you're liking what you're seeing and you'd like that guidance, then you can make the decision to create a profile.
That's great. Thank you so much. And definitely reassuring that the information is not being sold. And if someone does, there is the data policies right on the website that anyone can read before they sign up as well. Yeah. I'm not seeing any other questions in the chat. I guess, Sam, we're getting ready to wrap up, is there any last things you'd like to add to the conversation?
I would just like to say, you know, one of the best ways that we can get engagement on the portal is peer recommendations, mm-hmm. right? So as much as work as you're doing, Christine, to create awareness and so on, nothing's more impactful than if you're an employee or a retiree and you use this and you find value and you share you know, with colleagues or peers or friends that you've worked with, that, you know, this is a great resource, whether it's for you or a child that's approaching, you know, college age and so on. Sharing the good word will really help with that. And again, our goal is really just to try and get as much engagement as we possibly can. So if you can be champions, you know, the early adopters of the portal, if you can be the champions that help get that traction, we'd certainly appreciate it. And we're always open to feedback as well. So if there's a topic that you feel that maybe we're not covering, we want to hear it, and we will make changes to the portal based on the feedback that we receive.
That's great. Thank you so much, Sam. So we just dropped my email in the chat. So if anyone has any questions, and before we wrap up, I am going to launch our exit poll. Okay, nope, that is not the poll question. Sorry about this. All right, here we go. I got it. All right, I'm gonna relaunch our exit poll. If you could all just take that, this is just feedback for us to continue to improve our programming. And thank you so much, Sam, definitely echoing what you said. Definitely share this with your fellow state employees or state retirees and your colleagues, just to gain awareness about the program. And with that being said, next Thursday at April 8th at 12 p.m., we are going to continue our financial wellness webinars during Financial Literacy Month. We are going to host a webinar with Mass4U, which active state employees through our GIC insurance are eligible for this benefit. And then we also have the following two Thursdays in April, we will be doing an enrollment session with the SMART plan, which is the state's deferred compensation plan. And then the last Thursday, we'll be doing a Q&A with the SMART plan. So we're really excited about all the events that we have planned for April. So definitely I encourage you and to tell your colleagues to take a look at our mass.gov/finwell page And I am going to close the polling. Thank you all to everyone who participated. And thank you so much, Sam, for attending today and giving us a kind of a high level overview of the Enrich portal and all of the great resources. I think everyone is able, there could find something that will be applicable to them where they are in their journey. So if anyone has any questions or anything, you have my email, please reach out, and I'm happy to present about the FinWell program to any state agencies, to their HR departments, or their colleagues. So thank you so much again, Sam, for attending. I really appreciate it. I appreciate all of you who joined us today. I hope you and your families continue to stay well and have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. Thanks for your partnership.
Yes, we'll talk soon. Thank you. Bye-bye. Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Bye.